One more problem on identities. We are required to prove cot A minus cos A whole over cot A plus cos A is equal to cosecant A minus 1 divided by cosecant A plus 1. Shall we start with the left hand side? Yes. The left hand side is cot A minus cos A divided by cot A plus cos A. This is your left hand side. You are permitted to make use of any manipulation involving trigonometric ratios or identities to arrive at the right hand side. When I look at this, I can write cot A as cos A by sin A minus cos A, am I right? Whole over, when you look at this cot A, I can think of that as cos A by sin A plus cos A. Now if you carefully look at this, cos A is common. Okay. In case if someone finds it a little difficult to realize how cos A is common, I'm trying to tell you cos A is common. But in case if you are finding it a little difficult to identify how cos A is common, please write, I will rewrite this as cos A into 1 over sin A. I think you should permit me. Cos A by sin A is cos A into 1 by sin A, because cos A into 1 is cos A by sin A, minus cos A whole over, same thing I will do here, cos A into 1 over sin A plus cos A. Now I am sure you will be able to easily identify, yes sir, cos A is common. Correct my dear children, cos A is common. When I take cos A outside, I'll continue here. When I take cos A outside, what am I left with? 1 over sin A minus 1, because cos A has been taken out. So you're left with 1 by sin A minus 1. 1 by sin A minus 1. Whole over. Cos A, you can observe it is common. So if you take away cos A, you are left with 1 over sin A plus 1, because cos A has gone out, right? So 1 over sin A plus 1. Cos A cancels with cos A. You are left with 1 over sin A minus 1 whole over 1 over sin A plus 1. What is 1 over sin A? You all know, my dear children, sin A and cosecant A are reciprocals. So 1 over sin A is nothing but cosecant A minus 1 whole over 1 over sin A is cosecant A plus 1. That is your required right hand side. Small problem, very simple problem, right? Please write down.